is up, guys? It's your boy the Ass Berserker with another video, finally. These videos, I'm going to start to try to put out a good two again every week. I do have videos currently on my phone and on my computer that I can put out videos for. But today, since I did so good on my last anime cooking video, we're going to be making cream steak from the secret world of Arrietty. So I hope you guys enjoy this, like it, and also, always, comment if you know what video I should do next. I will always listen to comments. Till then, let's get into it. So another thing that I have been slacking on is me simplicing everything before I cook. So today, I actually did that. So that's just one less thing I have to worry about. So what we're gonna do first is we're going to get everything to be some plus and ready to go. We're gonna put some oil and butter into this pot and saute some vegetables. Choice of oil you can use either. I would recommend you either using vegetable oil or olive oil. I don't have olive oil on me. I went to the store and I bought some olive oil. Make sure the bottom gets covered with oil, and then to this we're gonna add some salted butter, sweet cream, so it gets a nice little bit of sweetness. Two tablespoons of butter. Just crank the heat up just a little bit, and then the goal is to try to melt the butter without burning it, which should be fairly easy. Just don't bring up your temperature of the stove too much. Another thing I've noticed in my videos, you guys can't hear my voice as well. I'm sorry for that. I've not bought a new microphone yet. So this is like phone microphone that's going off of right now. Slightly better, turn off. The butter has melted. You're gonna wanna put your vegetables in here to cook. I have all the vegetables cut up. There's cauliflower, broccoli, carrot. lot of vegetables. So. And as you guys know, as vegetables cook, they vegetables themselves will start to sweat. So just stop it. The vegetables from burning. So make sure they move them around. Turn the heat down. I had it on hot. Now I dropped it down to a 6, so it doesn't burn. And continue to mix it up until they're nice and soft. Our goal in doing this isn't to cook the vegetables, it's just to slightly soften. Now, if you want to while these cook, you can add a little bit more oil to them. Just a little bit, don't add too much. You don't want it to be, you don't want them to be overly oily. You just want the oil to help soften. Well, so you want to add a little bit of water. You can turn it back up. But if you don't cook without high, make sure you are constantly stirring, because vegetables will burn if you just leave. Also, this mix, there's leeks in it. The leeks, I should have separated this from all of this. I was thinking it completely out. But leeks aren't going to be cooked with this. If it gets into it, it's whatever. I'm going to be using the leeks to kind of make when I'm making it. Thank you. vegetables. I get the almost to where I want it to be. It is still hard, but slightly softer. And as you can see, before it was in the pot. You can also see it kind of soften up because before the pot was fuller, I'm pretty sure it was like right there before. And now that the vegetables are starting to soften, then it has gone down. Compressed out of there. Put it back on there and then cut the heat back down and add some more. Try to get the rest of the vegetables out. Like I said before, if the leeks go in there, it's fine. But you want this to be more leeks than any other vegetable. This is mostly leeks right now, so you can just leave those right there. And to this, we're gonna add our potatoes so they can be jerked. That's back in there. You can also add a little bit of olive oil, like you did before. Add a little bit more than I had before the potatoes. And then you wanna crank this back up. Cooking on high, you smoke burning, add water to it. And it's more than like, it's not actually burning. The oil itself is what's trying to burn. And like I did before, I'm gonna do this time. I'm gonna add this one to the spinner. Get the butter to go to the bottom and cover it with the black pepper. If you just pull it and add water to it. So it's something that's steaming there. Steam it. In a sense. Also, keep it from burning. Thank you. If you look at the potato fairly closely, you'll see the potato just like it. It says kind of functional essentially. That's what you're looking for. Let's continue to mix it up a little bit. I'm one thing I was advertising for you as well. Clean as you go. You can suck it up a few. The way that you can do it is, if you want to save on time, you could take instead of sauteing like I'm doing, you could always just boil all the vegetables and drain off the water. Keep drain the water so you can never drink it. And then this one's like, you can have a little bit more than before. I'm gonna put this on low. Cover this with some type of lid and put it inside the microwave so that it stay warm to a sense, I guess. Now what we're going to be doing next is making a roux. We're going to take some butter. Turn the heat up to a 4. Now it's just want to make the butter melt. Try to melt the butter without burning it. And then you can put your olive oil back. At the time, you won't believe it again. Now with the rest of the vegetables, you're going to put them inside with the butter that you just melted. And just saute it. I'm just going to show you can add more butter to add. So I like making the roux, like having something better to help melt the butter. More butter, but what you're gonna want to do next is I could not find fresh peas. I went to Publix, I went to Walmart, I went to Target, I could not find fresh peas. So I'm gonna be using parsley steamed fresh peas. You're not gonna steam it, of course. You just want it frozen. 1 tablespoon of butter. And then you won't need the butter anymore. Turn the heat up. Just to make sure the butter and the peas have melted and the butter have melted. The peas have melted. The ice that's on the peas have melted and the butter melts. When you're waiting for it to do that, you can clean up. This is melted, you're going to add a cup of flour. So what, 2 what, 2/3 a cup of flour, and add more if you need. This is all up. Like a half of a 1/3 of a cup. So I guess it'd be 6 cups of flour more to it. And then put the flour back when you don't get your flour. All the flour in with this. Once the flour has been combined, it'll salt up the butter, whatever's left of the butter and whatever sweat that the vegetables did, and it'll be good. Next, we're going to be aiming to add milk. For those that don't know, I am lactose intolerant, so I do not use regular milk. You can add your regular milk if you're not lactose. If you are lactose intolerant, try to find it. Functional allergic to it, almond milk that doesn't have vanilla extract in it. Vanilla extract, the vanilla has flavoring in it besides the almond milk, and make sure it's not sweet. Then you want to add just enough to where it's to where they're covered. Let's go ahead and just mix all this together. What you're trying to do by doing this is mixing the flour and the milk together. Start with thickening it up slightly. Now what you're gonna wanna do from here is to want that to come to a boil, but you also want to make sure you eye it. This milk does burn pretty easily, and the flour that's in that milk will make it burn even more easily. You want to grab yourself a good 2 to 3 cups of water. And as this continues to cook and it slowly starts to boil, it will thicken up. And as you guys can see, I have way too much vegetables there. And that's fine, because honestly, at the end of the day, I'm just going to freeze the rest and use it for whenever I need to use it. It's just vegetables that were cooked in vegetable oil butter. Technically, it's mise en place just with the potatoes. See, as you can see, it slowly started baking up back to how it was before. Which is what you were aiming for. This, you're going to want to slightly season it. I'm using pink Himalayan. You can use regular plain salt. I'm using pink Himalayan because I just want to use pink. And some pepper. See, it has taken up a lot more than it just was. This, by using the back of the spoon, just pour water into it. You can also turn this down. We start to add the mixture of potatoes. potatoes. Try to add as much potatoes to it as possible. It's the rest of it, like I said before. And you can just freeze it afterwards. You can freeze it with potatoes, but just let the rest of the water. And there you guys go. This is the green stew from the secret world of Arrietty. So I had some parsley. Now that all the vegetables in here, the only thing that's missing from here is to just let the vegetables slowly cook. And once they become nice and tender, you're good to go to eat it. That being said, guys, this is a, compared to all the videos I made in the past, this one's been 37, about 38 minutes, which is awesome. The only reason why it's so short is because I did all the mise en place early. And that's how I'm going to start doing it. Look forward to the next video. I should be dry after I do the editing for this video. I should be dropping the next video either Saturday or Sunday. Till then, see y'all later. Peace.